Let's look at scapular humeral rhythm. So as the name implies, it's the relationship between the scapula and the humerus as we go through glenohumeral motion. The scapula rotates 1 degree for every 2 degrees movement of the humerus. And so it basically allows an increased range of motion at the glenohumeral joint. If your scapula did not move, you would have about 90 degrees of glenohumeral abduction as your full range of motion, which you can imagine would be quite limiting. So what other motions do our scapula do on our thorax? So there's a few movements. One is elevation and depression, and that occurs in the frontal plane. So as you do shrugs in the gym, you're elevating and depressing your scapula. There is upward and downward rotation of the scapula. That's also in the frontal plane. The point of reference for rotation is the glenoid fossa. So if the glenoid fossa starts to point up, the scapula is upwardly rotating. If the glenoid fossa points down, the scapula has downwardly rotated. So as you go through abduction, you have upward rotation of the scapula. As you go through adduction, you have a downward rotation of the scapula. You also have frontal plane motion, and different terms are used for this. And so this is basically hunching your shoulders forward, and it's taking your scapula and abducting or protracting the scapula. And remember, abduction means away from the midline. The midline in this case are your spinous processes. So as you hunch your shoulders, you're pulling the scapula away from your spine. As you kind of push your shoulders back and your scapula go into adduction or retraction, you are putting the scapula towards the midline. We also have something called anterior and posterior tilt in the sagittal plane. And that's just basically the bottom triangle of your scapula, the bottom point, tilting out for anterior tilt, so the whole scapula tilting anteriorly, or tilting posteriorly. So, a task for you. For these glenohumeral joint motions, abduction, adduction, flexion, extension, horizontal abduction, and horizontal adduction, can you describe the scapular movements that go along with those motions? And this is a good topic for one of your biomechanical concept videos. All right, so let's look at the muscles. You have the trapezius, the serratus anterior, levator scapula, rhomboids major and minor, and pectoralis minor. These six muscles do not cross the glenohumeral joint. Their job is to take the scapula and create the optimal movement on the thorax for the scapula to enable maximal glenohumeral joint motion. So let's look at them one by one. Trapezius is huge diamond-shaped muscle in the back, in your upper back, extending from your occipital bone all the way down to your mid-thorax. It basically has three regions, upper, middle, and lower. The upper fibers extend the neck or the cervical spine and elevate the scapula. Middle fibers adduct or retract the scapula, and the lower fibers can depress the scapula, and upper and lower fibers together, the blue and the purple in the image, if they're both pulling, they create a force couple, and which results in upward rotation of the scapula. So it's an interesting muscle that it both elevates and depresses depending on which fibers you're contracting. Serratus anterior comes underneath the scapula into the anterior part of your ribs. If you look at some people who are really lean, it has a serrated edge. That's where the name serratus anterior came from. Serratus anterior pulls the bottom part of the scapula forward, and so it pulls it into upward rotation, and it pulls the scapula away from the midline into abduction. Levator scapula, since it's pulling on just this upper tip of the scapula, it pulls it, the glenoid fossa, into downward rotation and also elevates the scapula, just as the name implies, levator scapula. Rhomboids major and minor go from your spinous processes to the medial border of the scapula. They're at an angle, so not only do they adduct or retract the scapula, they also contribute to downward rotation. And then finally, the pectoralis minor. That's on the anterior part of our bodies. It goes from ribs 3 to 5 to the coracoid process of the scapula. And when that muscle shortens, it pulls that scapula into anterior tilt, and the way it's angled also into